One of the immediate risks is, of course, the use of a nozzle or the actual tubing itself, which enters the rectal area. When you physically insert that without visual guidance, you run the risk of perforation or damage of that area locally. And a perforation, especially a rectal perforation, sometimes leads to a permanent bag or an ostomy. It can be very complicated surgery to repair and can be quite dangerous. That's one risk there that's mechanical. Another mechanical risk is rupture of the colon somewhere else along the length of it because of the high amount of water pressure that's used or the large volume of water that goes in there. So we call that barotrauma or pressure trauma to the colon. So sometimes because of the large volumes of water, you can go on to absorb that water and it can lead to electrolyte imbalances. And then eventually the kidney and the heart and the lungs, you could have side effects from that. You know, water buildup in the body, heart failure, water buildup in the lungs, electrolyte disturbances which can damage or injure the kidneys and so on. There's an infectious risk that needs to be considered, especially in centers that don't practice proper either disposal of disposable nozzles and tubing or centers that don't sterilize properly. There's of course the issue of contamination. You know, one person may be harboring some sort of a viral agent like hepatitis B or C or HIV, and that could be transmissible to the next patient in the absence of proper, you know, disposable equipment, disposable tubing, or proper sterilization of the equipment.